You're listening to the KSN podcast, and today we're talking about bed bugs. Welcome to the KSN podcast, where you'll hear Kovitz, Shifrin, Nesbit attorneys as they share their experience and insight on legal issues surrounding community associations, collections, property tax appeals, and landlord-tenant law. I'm Bernie, and today we're joined by KSN attorney Michael Kreibich. Mike practices condominium, townhome, and homeowner association law. He has extensive background as a litigator. Mike, you've been practicing for over 15 years. You handle small to large communities in the Chicagoland area, city, suburban. You pretty much handle it all, right?
That's right, Bernie. Thanks. It's great to be here.
All right, so our topic today is bed bugs. Mike, you've seen quite a few associations who've struggled through bed bug infestations, and you can already feel the creepy crawlies as we talk about these.
Yes, a lot of what I talk about seems most relevant to large associations, but in fact, all association board members should take note and consider implementing a bed bug plan to protect their association. I can make a pretty strong argument that small associations actually can be impacted more than large associations based on the smaller budget and how important and widespread bed bug infestations can be.
All right, so speaking of infestations, let's jump right into it. So here's the problem. Bed bugs were declared a public nuisance by the city of Chicago in 2013. Some of the issues go without saying, but could you walk us through why bed bugs are such a pain?
Sure, let's do a little bit of history actually before we get into that. Prior to 2013, bed bugs kind of became more and more of an emerging issue in the city of Chicago. I, in fact, personally was involved in a couple of litigation matters at high-rise buildings in downtown Chicago. And as I said, before 2013, there was little or no guidance for the courts as to how to treat bed bug infestations. In fact, they were kind of treated like an ant infestation or a cockroach infestation, and the courts didn't deem them to be an emergency or, as you stated, a public nuisance. So before 2013, there were buildings in the city of Chicago that were having these widespread problems. In fact, I had one building that was right down on Lakeshore Drive that had almost a third of their units were infested with bed bugs. As you can imagine, that was a massive problem for that building that resulted in a huge budget hit for that association, and really what kind of led to was the precursor to the City of Chicago ordinance, and has given the associations downtown and in Chicago much more direction. Bed bugs are very small and difficult to detect. In fact, they're about 5 millimeters in length.
And what makes them unique, Mike, dissimilar to like ants and cockroaches, is that they do have a number of different traits, like they're good hitchhikers and a few other things that unfortunately you're probably familiar with in all the association work that you've dealt with.
Sure. So actually, you know, we found a couple of very important things when we were investigating bed bugs. How they get there, they can be brought in by unit owners and visitors alike. Travelers unknowingly pick them up in public venues, hotels, taxis, trains, airplanes. Pets, bags, and clothes can also bring them in. In fact, trying to find them is also interesting once they get into a unit. We ran into several different issues. One of them that jumps back in my memory was that we had to tear apart a couch to actually find the bed bugs that were inside the cushions. So you didn't even know they were in a unit and that they had burrowed themselves into cushions. So bottom line is they hide very well. They can live for months given favorable temperatures and feeding conditions.
And when you're talking about the couch, I mean, we're really talking about also pest preventative inspectors, subject matter experts that deals with this, that as board members are maybe trying to remedy a situation or dealing with a bed bug situation, it's not only the bed bugs, but there's also that other factor as well.
Sure, there's actually experts that specialize in this field. Beginning back in 2013 or around that time, a number of companies began acting as experts in this particular field.
And then, since we are talking about 2013, the relevant law, Chicago adopted that bed bug ordinance in 2013. So let's talk about the requirements that association and owners have to do, the specific actions that are involved because of that ordinance.
Sure. So as you stated, Chicago adopted the bed bug ordinance in 2013. There are requirements for both associations and the owners. Those requirements include that the condominium associations and cooperatives take specific action. Those actions are the establishment of a pest management plan for the detection and inspection and treatment of bedbugs within their buildings. Unit owners and lessees also have requirements. They must notify the governing association of known or suspected bedbug infestations in their unit, and they must cooperate with the association in the control, treatment, and eradication of bedbug infestations.
And Mike, regarding relevant case law, has anything really changed since 2013?
No, there really isn't any case law, and I think it's important to point out that prior to the ordinance and prior to 2013, the only case law that really was beneficial for the legal field related to hotels and motels. So that is what we really focused on, and what that said was that you needed to be proactive, which is what led to the City of Chicago's ordinance. The courts have made it plain and simple that doing nothing is not an option. The association must be involved in mitigation if it hopes to successfully insulate itself from liability in legal actions brought by residents.
And when we talk about liability, Mike, associations are best protected from potential liability when they do what things?
Sure. Protection is simple. Again, being proactive. You need to have a bedbug plan or policy in place. You need to actively work to prevent infestations and aggressively address any reports of bed bugs.
All right, Mike and I are going to take a quick break, but when we get back, we'll get into the specifics on how associations can better equip themselves to address bed bugs.
I'm Attorney Kelly Elmore, and I'd like to ask you if you've downloaded the KSN app. Here are some of the app's features: 24/7 real-time access to KSN's collection status online, CSO portal featuring updates on active collection, foreclosure, and landlord-tenant matters, articles and booklets authored by KSN's experienced association tax and landlord-tenant attorneys, access to our schedule of upcoming educational events, and you can view snapshot profiles of all KSN attorneys with contact info and mobile accessibility. The KSN app is now available for free download in the iTunes App Store for your iPhone and iPad. The app is also available for free download in the Google Play Store for your Android phone or Android tablet. Just search for Kovitz, Shifrin, Nesbit. We invite you to download the KSN app and learn what our law firm can do for you. We look forward to demonstrating how Kovitz, Shifrin, Nesbit has earned the trust of thousands of clients for over 30 years.
And we're back. I'm here with attorney Michael Kreibich, and we're discussing bed bugs. So Mike, let's get into what kind of a plan an association in Chicago should adopt.
The association's pest management plan should give clear guidance to all residents as to the steps to take if they suspect they have a bed bug infestation. This plan should include instructions on how to report an infestation, a description of the inspection process and options, a description of the treatment process and options, and a summary of resident rights and obligations.
And further, should the policy explain who's financially responsible for all this?
Always a question that I get asked is who's going to be responsible for what as it relates to costs. That absolutely should be completely spelled out in any policy.
And we've discussed liability, financial responsibility, any recommendations on how to prevent infestations. And obviously, you're an attorney, you're not a pest mitigation expert, but again, unfortunately, you've seen a lot of these infestations in associations.
Sure, education is key. The City of Chicago, the Environmental Protection Agency, and HUD have each published educational pamphlets that are online. Associations can also hire bed bug exterminators to conduct a preventative routine inspection. Keep in mind that the Illinois Condominium Property Act does not obligate unit owners to allow the association access to the unit interior for preventative maintenance, so you may have some owners who refuse. It's key to understand the difference between a voluntary inspection and a mandatory inspection. A voluntary inspection is when you are trying to be proactive in advance of a known infestation. Mandatory inspections are inspections that take place once an infestation is known.
And Mike, whether the inspection is mandatory or voluntary, immediate response is crucial.
Sure. Inspections to the unit and all units surrounding a unit should be performed as quickly as possible to determine the extent of the problem and to prevent it from spreading. Inspection experts would call this a clover leaf approach. This is where you have all of the units up, down, side to side, and all around a unit that has a known infestation must also be inspected to ensure that the bed bugs have not spread.
And Mike, in the scenario of a mandatory inspection, how would that work?
The association with a mandatory inspection can demand access to a unit to protect the common elements and other surrounding units. If an owner refuses to grant such access, a lawsuit could be filed to seek a court order granting access. Unfortunately, bedbug treatments are notoriously invasive procedures. Furniture, linens, clothing, and other unit furnishings that could harbor stowaway pests must first be removed. Sometimes this even includes baseboards.
And this is where you get into common treatments that include the using of chemicals throughout the unit and heating the unit.
Sure, those are two good examples of treatment types for bedbugs.
And I think this is where we'll agree, Mike, we'll defer to professional bedbug exterminators that should be consulted, because ultimately they're going to determine the most effective treatment plan for your association, given the scope of the infestation, right?
Sure, we would always rely on the expert's advice.
So Mike, this is all specific to Chicago, but it seems this is just good practices for associations.
While the ordinance is specific to the city of Chicago, it would always be sound legal advice for an association, even outside of the city of Chicago, to have an infestation or pest remediation plan in place. What it does is it avoids future costs for something that is unforeseen and can end up being a budget buster for associations.
And what do you recommend for association board members or property managers, for that matter, who are looking for more guidance?
Associations must continue to take the threat of bed bugs seriously and develop and follow a clear and known plan. The cost of prevention, detection, and remediation is far less than what costs may be incurred due to an association's failure to plan accordingly.
And this is where consulting with an attorney, just like you would consult with a bed bug exterminator or professional, makes sense.
Absolutely. An attorney can help an association get in compliance with the city ordinance or make a smart plan to prevent future litigation.
Again, Mike, good guidance, good information. Thanks for joining me today.
My pleasure.
That was KSN attorney Michael Kreibich. He practices condominium, townhome, and homeowner association law in the city of Chicago and the surrounding suburbs. Kovitz, Shifrin, Nesbit is an experienced legal resource ready to provide you with quality advice and exceptional service. We look forward to demonstrating how we have earned the trust of thousands of association clients over the past 35 years. If you'd like to reach Michael Kreibich or any of KSN's experienced attorneys, please call 855-537-0500, or you can visit ksnlaw.com, complete the contact form, and send us a message. Thanks for listening. The music for the show is brought to you by freepodcastthemes.com. Please note that the material contained on the KSN podcast is for informational purposes only and does not constitute legal advice. No attorney-client relationship is established by your review or receipt of the information contained on the KSN podcast. You should not act on the information discussed on the KSN podcast without first obtaining legal advice from an attorney duly licensed to practice law in your state. While Kovitz, Shifrin, Nesbit has made every effort to include up-to-date information on the KSN podcast, the law can change quickly. Accordingly, please understand that information discussed on the podcast may not yet reflect the most recent legal developments. Material is not guaranteed to be correct, complete, or up-to-date. Kovitz, Shifrin, Nesbit reserves the right to revise or update the information and statements of law discussed on the podcast at any time without notice, and disclaims any liability for your use of information or statements of law discussed on the podcast or the performance of the podcast generally. KSN Podcast may be considered advertising in some jurisdictions under applicable laws and/or ethical rules and regulations.